truth, if you speak now. So it's my name. It's like an introduction. Well, I will articulate my presentation in three points. First, I will speak about the MIH, Musée International d'Horlogerie, implication in the watchmaking field as an intangible heritage. Secondly, I will focus on the implementation of cultural policies at various levels and explain how the museum is involved in these policies or not involved sometimes. And finally, I will present you the key purpose of the future exhibition regarding ICH cultural policy and in view of the candidature of craftsmanship, mechanical watchmaking and art mechanics on the UNESCO representative. MIH is a public entity in the city of La Chaux-de-Fonds, Switzerland, the UNESCO World Heritage City regarding its town planning and constructed by and for watchmaking. MIH is one of the largest museums in the world and largely dedicated to time measurement. According to the convention of 2003, MIH belongs to the field of expertise relating to traditional craftsmanship. Origin of ICH issues in the museum can be traced back to the earliest collection. In 1865, the watchmaking collection was created by professors of the watchmaking school of La Chaux-de-Fonds. And the purpose was teaching. Objects were already considered for learning, studying, and passing on watchmaking expertise. MIH was set up as a museum in 1902 and physically detached from the premises of the school in 1974. ITH is in the heart of the activities and the exhibition concepts then, symbolized by the subtitle Man and Time. The promotion of watchmaking expertise formed an integral part of the museum's program as defined by Georges-Henri Rivière. In a report prior to the creation of the museum in 1963, the famous director of the International Council of Museums, also founder of the National Museum of Popular Arts and Traditions in Paris, Rivière was commissioned to study the city of La Chaux-de-Fonds Museum collection. His report highlighted the need for an approach including not only the technical perspective, but humanist, social, and cultural perspectives. Nowadays, MIH involves various of the watchmaking tradition at various events. First, regarding the collections, they are involved in the acquisition, conservation, exhibition of artifacts made and or donated by craftsmen, watches, clocks, automats. And tools together with them we build the collection of tomorrow. They are involved through collecting past and present documents produced by practitioners, archive from independent watchmakers, from association of watchmakers, from students. in this case, the museum is a memory keeper of the practitioners. I was in temporary exhibition that we can see. For instance, Lama Eluti had a tool in 1987, or lately, Artisan Don Craftsman of Time in 2050, about independent watchmaker work and association. And last one in last year, Evan Troisson Rings from Street Cabras, about a restoration project of collection. Practitioners are involved in exhibition for their expertise, for their collections too, and in events, for instance, the Urban Heritage Days. MIH involves various of watchmaking skills with marks of recognition given to them, superior prize we give each year. And MIH is an active player too, because craftsmen and craftswomen involved through their practice itself, like the presence of watchmakers working in a workshop, they integrated in the exhibition space, the permanent exhibition, as you see in the middle of the museum. And the restoration center right is played an important role during the ecological crisis from 1975 to 1985 and after it, and now played a role for planning new watchmakers' restaurants. I come to the next point of my presentation, that how MIH is concerned by cultural policy. The Switzerland federal structure is based on the principle of subsidiarity. The Swiss Cultural Promotion Act stipulates that the Confederation may support museums working actively to safeguard cultural heritage, in particular by allocating financial aid. I think that Vitaly will speak about this a bit later. At cantonal, regional and municipal levels, the population of the canton of Neuchâtel was invited in 2011 to participate in the process of defining the canton's living traditions. It was a bottom-up process. Watchmaking does not feature on the Neuchâtel list, even though watchmaking heritage is referred to in all political discourse and also used by companies in their communication. Watchmaking does, however, feature on the federal list as an intercantonal tradition, so including Neuchâtel. That's a top-down process. In 2018, the canton revised its Cultural Heritage Safeguarding Act and officially recognized watchmaking heritage, and in future will grant financial support to institutions involved in safeguarding it. Since 2016, guidelines from the Cultural Affairs Department of La Chaux-de-Fonds, the municipal level, support the promotion, launch, and coordination of initiatives highlighting tangible and intangible cultural heritage. This formulation demonstrates, however, that policy does not really recognize pre-existing approaches in watchmaking field, and that regarding legislation, ITH is quite a new concept. Otherwise, watchmaking heritage have to deal with economic interests. And in short, a museum must find place amongst new cultural, economic, jurist policy due to the necessity and interest of watchmaking companies too. The interests are sometimes or most often contradictory. Recognition and financial support is now possible thanks to cultural policies in all levels of the state. Regarding watchmaking, the expectation from cultural policies, coordination between actors, and definition of the role of the museum, the budget of manage in the field of ITH. So, points by 2020, an important step in ITH issues in the field of watchmaking could be reached, thanks to the inclusion of craftsmanship of mechanical watchmaking and art mechanics as a UNESCO representative list. MIH should play a specific role as a key partner for the candidature under the aegis of the Swiss federal state. This perspective generates different expectations, you can see, and how to deal with expectation while remaining in the line with museums' missions, museums' expressions, and museums' resources. The answer, an answer, will be a photography exhibition together with Musée du Temps de Besançon, the candidature is a binational one. Photography is not the classic way to manage with ITH, but I think at the same time it represents an opportunity to reflect on the long-term museum's practice in light of the challenges of cultural and economic policies. In very few words, the exhibition project invites the bearers of the tradition to reflect on the impact of territorial and cultural policies and economic issues on their practice, and how their practice is reflected in the public arena through images and talks. The aim will be to show the contradictions rather than to try to erase them. This involves adopting a critical approach to underline if and how, if yes, ITH being part of cultural policies and if watchmaking companies marketing has the effect of skewing the development of the tradition to make it match an imaginary model. With that in mind, photography will be used and accepted as a medium which has the potential to socialize, if not to practice, at least its representation to the public, for instance, due to its formalization or folklorization for cultural policies or for economic goals. According to me, the museum has to ask visitors about their own perception of intangible heritage and about the biases which interfere with this perception and since the 19th century, the time at which watchmaking began to be built up as a national tradition in Switzerland. The question is how do we, each one and we together, define or redefine watchmaking craftsmanship? I would be happy to hear from you about this specific project, and I will finish. Thank you for your attention.